guys, welcome back to my channel if you've been here before, and if you haven't been here before, thanks for visiting. My name is Carolina, I live in New York City, and I make videos on sustainable designer fashion and other fashion and designer related things that I feel like talking about. So if that sounds interesting to you, please like this video down below and hit the big red button to subscribe to my channel because it really helps out my teeny tiny new YouTube channel, and I'd appreciate it. Today's video is going to be a super impromptu unboxing slash reveal. I was totally not expecting to get this bag. I almost bought this bag like 4 months ago and then canceled my order, so this is gonna be an interesting one. The bag that I'm gonna be showing you guys today is from Bottega Veneta, and I'm really trying to fight it, but I think that they are now my new favorite brand. I am kind of like trying to not admit that they're my favorite brand at the moment because they're so trendy and like, that feels wrong. That feels like I'm just following the trend, but I truly think I just really love their bags. Like, they really match my aesthetic. Let's jump right into this reveal, and once I show you guys what it is, we'll have a little chat about how and why I ended up getting this bag. Here's the bag. This is not actually the dust bag that came with the bag. This is the dust bag that came with the bag. This is one of like the older Bottega Veneta bags from their old branding. From the before time, and by before time I mean before Daniel Lee. It's brown and it has the very small Bottega Veneta lettering. I think this bag is kind of ugly, so I've been storing this new bag in one of my other Bottega Veneta dust bags that has the new white and green branding on it, which I think is so beautiful. Now that I'm thinking about it, you know how like green bags are super in trend right now and green is really popular as a color at the moment, even though it definitely wasn't last year? Did Bottega Veneta start that? Because they came out with like all their green branding and now green is on the rise, whereas before it was like kind of considered an ugly color. So the bag I got, you can kind of, she's poking out of the bag a little because she's very big for this dust bag. And we're just gonna pull her right out. You can probably already tell what it is from the shape of the bag. It is the Don't Blame bag. JK, this is the Bottega Veneta pouch bag in the Intrecciato leather. In the color Noir, aka the bougie way of saying black. Let's take a second to appreciate her little dumpling beauty. I keep calling her a dumpling, obviously, because, I mean, this girl looks like a dumpling, but that's okay. I love dumplings. I love eating dumplings, so this is a great representation of the food that I like. I have her fully stuffed at the moment, so she's very fluffy and poofy, but if I take the stuffing out, she's like, she melts down. This feels like a basketball or something. All right, so this bag has definitely been considered and still kind of is one of the trendiest bags that has come out in the last couple of years. This bag originally came out in like February of 2019, so it's been out for, God, what year is it? It's 2021. Okay, it's very easy to lose all sense of time during a year-long pandemic. This bag has been out for 2 years now. I mean, it's not as super hot and super new and super trendy as it was when it first came out, but it's still definitely like riding the trend wave as we speak. The pouch, I believe, was Daniel Lee's like first showstopper bag that he created for Bottega Veneta, and originally it was only released in a couple of neutral colors in the smooth leather, and that was the iteration that like just blew Bottega Veneta up into a whole new level of what they used to be. I remember seeing those bags come onto the scene, and I did not realize they were Bottega Veneta because they didn't have the Intrecciato, and that's kind of the only way you can tell a bag is from Bottega Veneta, especially back then. So when I saw them, I was like, whoa, those are cool bags. Who are they by? And then I like saw that it was Bottega Veneta and I was shocked because it was so different from anything that they had ever done before. And whenever they started releasing the Intrecciato versions, I was so sold because I was just like, oh, this is like Bottega Veneta's version of a logo plus the super trendy like oversized clutch vibe. And I've loved them ever since. This bag currently retails for $3,200 new from Bottega Veneta. I literally got the deal of the century. I bought this bag pre-loved from Michael's Consignment, which is a consignment store here in New York City that is one of my favorite stores. I talk about them all the time on this channel. They have an online store, so if you're not in the New York City area, absolutely check them out. They have so many great pieces. But anyways, I got this bag for $1,200. Can we just take a second and do the math? That's $2,000 off what the retail price of this bag is. And no, this bag is not like falling apart. I don't know why they had it priced so low. They always like price bags and accessories so far under retail, and I'm always shocked because, I mean, Fashion File and The Real Real and all of these other big resale sites for bags always overprice things. And I forget that local consignment stores usually have very fair prices for secondhand bags because I mean, they're still secondhand bags. Like, yes, it's a designer bag, but it has been used before. So yeah, very, very, very happy with the price that I got this bag for, because I've always adored this bag, but I just thought it was a little too expensive. I think it is worth the price point because Bottega Veneta does have very incredible quality, but I just wasn't willing to pay that much for the weaved pouch. I was willing to pay that much for my Bottega chain cassette because, oh my god, that bag is my soulmate. But for this one, I always thought to myself, I'll wait around for a deal and then I'll get it. I had no intention of buying this bag that day. I just walked into Michael's, was just browsing around because I had nothing else to do, and I saw this sitting on the shelf and I was like, no. And then I asked them to pull it down and I asked them how much it was and they said $1,200, and I was like, yep, that bag is leaving with me today. You know what? That's not even true, because I actually did stand around in the store trying to decide whether I was gonna buy this or not for like an hour. But you know when like you see something in a store or there's something you really want and your subconscious already knows that you're gonna be buying it and you're gonna be leaving the store with it that day, but like your brain hasn't processed that yet and you're like, maybe, I don't know, but really, you know you're gonna leave with it that day. And guys, funny story is that I actually purchased this bag from Selfridges in the Bordeaux slash dark red color at the start of January. And in the time frame of them processing the order, I saw my Bottega Veneta Jodie bag on Joma Shop in like this brown suede for $1,000 compared to like the retail price of $2,500. And I canceled my Selfridges order and went for the Bottega Jodie instead, which makes me think that this was fate. Let's go over features on this in case you're interested in maybe getting this bag or you just wanna see another beautiful bag. So here's her with all of her contents emptied out. She's just this like very malleable, squishy, conforms to your body kind of bag, which I really love. It's a very different vibe than structured bags. The leather on this bag is just so luxurious. Like, shout out Bottega for their incredible leather quality. This is my third bag from them, and each of them is just so wonderful. The opening is just this kind of snap closure. There's like a metal bar that's built into the bag, so makes this little snapping turtle sound when you close it. It also makes it super convenient to hold. Something that always concerned me about this bag was that I was really worried that, you know, I would just drop this bag while I was walking down the street. I was totally wrong. This metal bar that's built into the bag effectively makes this clutch a top handle. You're not gonna drop this while you're walking down the street unless you're super clumsy, but then how do you hold any of your bags up? The inside of the bag is weirdly super huge. Like, does this not look like something that the witch in Halloween Town would be carrying around, where it's just like an endless bag? I wouldn't recommend putting a bunch of stuff in this bag. It gets really heavy when you have a lot in it. I mean, if you're really strong, then by all means, put like 3 books in here. I've only used this out once, and when I did use it, I had no issues worrying about, oh, do I have to play Tetris with my bag? What can I take? Oh, what if this doesn't fit? Like, no. I had like wallet, sunglasses, mini pochette. I had a mini water bottle in here at one point too. The inside is also fully lined with leather, and there's a little Bottega Veneta stamp. The specific pouch that I have is actually one of the very initial releases from Bottega's iteration of the pouch with the Intrecciato leather, because this is still the kind of old Bottega thin weaving style, as opposed to their newer thick weaving style. And if I hold these next to each other, it becomes super clear that this is the old Bottega thin weaving. I cannot tell you guys how much I love this bag. I know that, like, that's kind of a trendy bag, blah, 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 it's so trendy. But I mean, it's just a clutch and there's no logo on it. And Bottega Veneta's weaving is classic. They've been doing this for so long. They've been renowned for the craftsmanship on their weaved leather for so long. I am personally of the very strong opinion that some of Bottega's current trendy bags are going to be classics, and particularly the pouch in the Intrecciato leather. I do think that the ones that aren't in the Intrecciato weaving, that are just in the smooth leather, will probably look a little more outdated as time goes on, but I think the Intrecciato ones are definitely a very good buy if you're looking for a long-lasting bag that's still kind of trendy. I personally don't buy bags for the trends. I just buy whatever I freaking like, and man, I freaking like this bag. I think the best part about the pouches as well is that they're so fashion accessible, in the sense that it looks like it's a very, very like high fashion bag, but this works so well with casual outfits and just normal outfits. It's really easy to style. I have already worn this with like a big poofy coat and a t-shirt and jeans. I don't know what it is about Bottega. They're making some very, very versatile bags at the moment because my chain cassette is also so versatile. What do you guys think of this bag? I know that people are very split on Bottega Veneta in general, and they either like have fallen head over heels for them, or they're like, ew, why would you buy any of those bags? Obviously, I've fallen head over heels for them, but I'd love to hear your guys' thoughts in the comment section down below. Let me know what you think. Do you love her? Do you hate her? Are you like, eh, I really don't care. All right, guys, that's it for today's video. As usual, don't forget to like this video down below and hit the big red button to subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next video.